Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in AutoCAD 2018 in PA.
If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_018_DIAB and 00_014_DIAB where you saved them. Make the file 00_014_DIAB as a current file. Go to the Home tab, Layer panel, and click the Isolate command. Select the wall and the verandas. Press Enter. AutoCAD hide all the other objects except this line. Now click into this area to use a window selection to select the entire object in this drawing. Hold down your Control and Shift key and type letter C on your keyboard. At the prompt, specify this point, zoom in into this area and click on this point. Now activate the draw in 00_018_DIAB to make it the current drawing. Go to the view control and click the custom view. Select the top view in the menu that appears. Now hold down your control key and type letter V on your keyboard. At the prompt, specify insertion point. Click any area above this drawing. Now make the 00_014_DIAB the current drawing. Use a window selection to select this entire drawing. Hold down your Control plus Shift and type letter C on your keyboard. At the prompt, specify base point prompt. Click this area. Back to the drawing 00_018_DIAB to make it the current drawing. Hold down your Control key and type letter V on your keyboard. At the specified insertion point, click to paste the drawing. Go to the Quick Access toolbar and click the Save As button. This will bring the Save Drawing As dialog box. Change the file of type if you plan to open this drawing into earlier version of AutoCAD. And rename the drawing to 00_019_DIAB and click the Save button. Go to the Quick Access toolbar and make the first floor slab as the current layer. If you use the previous release of AutoCAD, you don't have this option. So go to the Layer Properties panel and make the first floor slab layer as the current layer. Go to the Home tab, Draw panel, and select the Polyline command. At the specified start point, zoom in into this area to start the polyline in this area. Move your mouse cursor and hover it into this area, then move slowly into the left. When you see the intersection object snap, click. Continue to click until you close the figure with the polyline. Type C on your keyboard to close the figure. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the Rectangle command. At the specified first corner point, or click this area, then click on this area. Now select the rectangle that you just drew and hover your mouse cursor into this grid. Move down your mouse cursor and select the second option, Add Vertex. Then move back into the polyline and click. Now AutoCAD add a new vertex into this segment. Hover the mouse cursor into this grid and click it. When it's turned red, move it to the right and snap it into this endpoint. Now hover the mouse cursor again to this grid and select Add Vertex. Then move back into the same area and click. Then click this vertex. When it's turned red, move it and snap it into this area. Hover the mouse cursor again and click Add Vertex. Go back and click into the same area. Now click this grid. When it's turned red, move it and snap it into this area. I think we add more vertex than we need. Hover the mouse cursor into this grid and select Remove. Press Escape to get out of the command. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel and select the Polyline command again. Start the polyline from this corner, click on this corner, continue to click until you close the figure. Type C on your keyboard to close the figure. Go to the Home tab, Layer panel and click the make the cabbage layer the current layer. We want to draw a temporal lines in this area. Start the line command. Hover your mouse cursor into this area. Now move to the left. Type 6 inches on your keyboard and press enter. Turn on your audio mode if it's not on by pressing the F8 key or clicking the audio button in the status bar. Move down your mouse cursor until when the line pass this yellow line, click. Press enter twice to end the command and start the command again. Hover the mouse cursor into this area and move up. Now type 6 inches, press enter. Move to the right and click. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the Home tab, Layer panel and make the first floor slab layer as the current layer. Go to the Home tab, Draw panel and select the polyline command. As the specified start point comes, start from this area, continue to click this corner, then type C on your keyboard and press enter to close the figure. Go to the Home tab, Layer panel and click the Make Current button. Select this object, the cabbage layer, to make it the current layer. Go to the Home tab, Draw panel and select the line command. Select at the specified start point, click on this corner and move down your mouse cursor into this area. Press escape to get out of the command. Press enter to start the line command again. Hover the mouse cursor into this area and move down. When you see the intersection object, snap, click. Move the mouse cursor up and click. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the Home tab, Layer panel and select the Make Current button. Select the polyline that you just drew to make the first floor slab as the current layer. Go to the Home tab, Draw panel and select the Rectangle command. At the specified start point of prompt, click into this area and move your mouse cursor. Hover the cursor into this area and to this area. Now move. When you see the temporal intersection, click. Start the rectangle command again by pressing the space bar on your keyboard. Then start the rectangle from this corner to this corner. Go to the Home tab, Layer panel and click the Isolate button. Select this veranda object and the 2D wall object. Press enter on your keyboard. AutoCAD hide all the other objects except this object. Use a window selection to select the two plans that you copy from the previous plan and erase them. Now go to the Home tab, Layer panel and click the Unisolate button. AutoCAD bring back the outline we draw in the previous steps. Select these temporal lines, these lines, and erase them. Now we're going to draw reference lines just in case we move the slab and we need to use them as a reference for some reason. So go back and bring the cabbage layer by going to the Home tab, Layer panel and make the cabbage layer the current layer. Go to the Home tab, Draw panel and select the polyline command. Start from this point to this point. Press enter. Press enter again. Start a line from this point to this point. Press enter. Now select all these polylines. This polyline. Go to the Home tab, Modeling panel, and select the Extrude command. AutoCAD asks for extrusion height. Type 6 inches on your keyboard and press Enter. AutoCAD extrude the object 6 inches above. To get a better understanding of the extrusion, go to the view control and click the top view. Select the SE isometric view. Now we have some solid inside this solid, but you cannot see them clear because of the visual style. So but before you proceed, let's select this solid and move them to the correct layers. Now go to the Home tab, Layer panel, and select the first floor slab layer. Press Escape. Go to the visual style and click the realistic. Select 2D wireframe. Now select these two slabs and move them to the first floor slab layer. Press Escape to get out of the command. Now we need to copy this slab into the right location. So select this slab, and use the Move command. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel, select the Move command. Zoom in into this area and click at the top of this vertex. Now turn on your auto mode, turn off your auto mode if the auto is on, and snap it at this vertex. You see, now we have another slab to move, but if we are not great this reference plan, it's difficult for us to move them into the right position. The next, when we want to move this slab, we use this reference line, this line as our reference. Select this slab, and go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the Move command. Zoom in into this area and use this vertex at the base point. Move the mouse cursor and snap into this area. Go to the visual style control and click the 2D wireframe. Change the visual style to realistic. Now go to the Home tab, Layer panel, and click the isolate command. Select this slab, this line, and press Enter. AutoCAD hide all the other objects except this slab. Now we need to subtract this slab from this slab. Change the visual style back to 2D wireframe. Now select this slab and go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the Copy command. Use the endpoint of this endpoint as the reference, and you copy the slab here. Press Escape. Now select this slab and use the Move command. By going to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the Move command. At the prompt specifying base point prompt, click on this vertex. At the specify first point, or use the first point displacement prompt, move the mouse cursor and click on this area. Go to the Home tab, Solid Edit panel, and select the Subtract command. Select this slab and press Enter. Then select this slab, press Enter. AutoCAD subtract the smaller slab from the bigger slab. To see the result, go to the visual style control and click the 2D wireframe. Select realistic. You see, a hole is being created on this slab. Now we need to move this slab into the Z axis. To do that, select the slab and go to the Home tab, Modify panel, and select the Move command. Turn on your auto mode if it's not on. Use at the specifying base point prompt, use this temporal line as a base point, then move your mouse cursor into the Z direction. Type 7 feet on your keyboard and press Enter. Now select this slab again and use the Move command. At the specifying base point, Use this temporal line as the base point, and at the specifying second point, or use the first point as a displacement, move your mouse cursor and click on this vertex. Now the slab in the right location. So go to the top view by clicking the top view in the view key. Select this object and click the delete key on your keyboard. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and click the unisolate command. This brings all your objects. Go to the view control and click the top view. Select the SE South isometric. Alright, in this tutorial, you use a polyline to create a slab. We use the subtract command and we move the slab into the right location. In the next tutorial, we're going to copy the first floor above the ground floor. So if you find this tutorial useful, please click the like button and share it to your friend. If you want to follow along or you want any other tutorial, please leave a comment below. If you want to follow along in this series or any other tutorial in my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class.